Hovertek. Just a button away.
In this video tutorial, I'll be explaining how to bypass verified boot is enabled in SP Flash 2. You usually get this error when you're trying to flash maybe some secure boot devices, and it looks something like this. Although the error code could be different. You have verified boot is enabled, please download signed image, your partition -verified.img or disable verified boot. So you are getting this error because you are trying to flash to a restricted partition. Now, some fixes that you could try are to use the latest version of SP Flash 2, to try using format all plus download, then retry download only. But only do this when you have the auth file or you are using the MTK auth bypass. You could also consider skipping that partition altogether. If it's not that important, you can ignore the partition and flash the others. But when this particular fixes don't work, then this is one approach you should consider. Now you are going to need the firmware for your device, preferably a factory or signed firmware. You need the PGPT. If your firmware doesn't come with one, then you can generate one using WWR. I'll link to a guide on WWR backup. Then you are going to need, of course, SP Flash 2, your drivers and everything you need for an SP Flash 2 flash. And of course, I'm going to need hex editor. Make sure you download that one. I'll link to that. And then an online hex calculator. We'll be using this website. I'll attach the link also in the description. All right. So we have everything we need in place. And of course, a notepad, whether notepad plus plus or regular notepad. Now let's assume I'm trying to flash. I'm going to load the scatter file here. I'm loading the scatter file. And let's say I'm trying to flash these files, for example, and LAF, this is an LG scatter file. LAF keeps giving me errors. Now LAF helps you enter download mode on LG devices. Now let's say I really need to flash LAF, but it just keeps giving me that verified error. Now what I could do is to use this trick to flash to the LAF partition. Now first off, you need to open the scatter file. You would have that from your firmware. So I'll open the scatter file for this particular firmware. I'll do that with Notepad++. Now I'll locate the LAFA to be precise, because this is an AB device. So LAFA, this is the partition I'm trying to flash. I wouldn't flash. So you look just above that partition. Here I have boot A just above it, because a scatter file is linearly arranged. Scatter file is just like a map of all the partitions on your device, where they start and where they stop, so that flash tools can easily locate them and know where to write their respective files. So that's what the scatter file is, just like a map. So on the scatter file, everything is arranged linearly as they appear. Alright, so boot A comes just above LAF A. Now, because I can flash boot A in SP Flash 2, but I can't flash LAF A, I'm going to use this trick. Now, first off, you need to get the address for boot A. Alright, so let's say this is here. Alright. So I have the partition, I have the start address, and I have the partition size. So I get the partition size for boot A. You are going to ignore the 0x part. You don't need that for the x calculation. So I paste that here. Then I'm going to get the size for LAFA, partition size. Also, copy. I'm adding, then calculate. Alright, so this is the value. So you copy this and you come back under boot A, and then you change the partition size to the sum. Alright. and then you can delete the LF partition. Remember, you just one space between. All right, so here it is. Now you save. Now the next thing, you open hex editor. I'm using HXD. First, I'm going to prepare the PGPT for flashing. Now, usually the PGPT you would have would be roughly 512 kilobytes. Let me, yeah, or maybe even larger. All right, something like this. This is much larger. So what we want to do is to reduce the size to allow flashing. So first, we load the PGPT here in hex editor. Now you scroll gradually till you get to the last partition. You can take under the decoded text field, the section. You can see I have content all through here. Alright, so content seems to have ended here. Alright, so now we want to get rid of all the zeros after the content. So you select this row of zeros, you copy. Now you click on search, replace. Come under hex values, paste the zeros. You leave replace with blank. You set search direction to forward. And you click replace all. You click OK. So just wait while it replaces all those zeros. So what we are trying to do here is just reduce the size of PGPT to allow flashing. All right, so that is done. Now you can save the PGPT. Alright, you save it. Now the next step, we are going to append the laugh image. Now from scatter file, you can see that I will just control Z a little. From the scatter file, you can see that laugh is this particular file. You can locate it here, and boot is this particular file. Under file name, we can locate it here. Alright. So I will append this file, lab file, to the boot in hex editor. So first I open the boot. Then I open the lab. So now, because boot comes before laugh in the scatter file, I will select all the contents of laugh under the hex and I'll copy. Then come to boot. You scroll down to the very bottom of boot and then you can highlight somewhere here. And then you control V, you paste, you click OK to confirm. So now you see that that has appended laugh to boot, so you save. Now let's look at the file size before. You can see the file size before around 40 megabytes. So when we save, you will now have something larger. All right, So you can see it's now larger. Now you are ready to load the scatter file in spflash 2. We have our patch PHPT reduced in size. Everything seems okay here. Now back to spflash 2. Now you can see how this is loaded. This is before any modification. You can see I have laugh, I have boot showing just fine. So now I've updated the scatter file and the files. I'm going to reload the scatter file. Now if you did everything correctly, you see that LAF is no longer on the list. All you should have is just boot, a much larger boot. Now with all the other files of course loaded, now you're going to flash this selection using format all plus download. Now some devices require that you have loader for you to flash them, some don't, so just take note of that if yours does. And when doing format all, you need to have files assigned for any ticked partition. Any partition that appears on this list needs to have a file attached to it. Now, if you don't have a file for a partition appearing here, you can just set a download to false for that partition in your scatter file. Look at the partition in your scatter file, set its download from true to false, then you save and reload the scatter file. That should remove it from this list. So everything on this list should have a file on that location here attached to it. Then you do format all plus download. Now when this is done, after doing format all plus download and it is done, you come back to, I'll not be doing this because I assume you already have the basic of spflash 2. Alright. So you come back to PGPT. Now you set its download to true. And then you grab the file name for PGPT. This is it right here. You can see it's gone from about 8 megabytes to like 10 kilobytes. So this will allow flashing. And then under the scatter file, and you set file name from none to this, and then you save. Now notice that PGPT was on the list during this first flash. All right so now you reload the scatter file and PGPT should now appear on the list. Now we have it. So what you do now is to untick every other item and you flash just PGPT using download only. But some devices, as I say, require you to flash preloader also. So you might need to tick preloader also for some devices, not necessarily all. Then you flash the PGPT and you can do a readback if you want. You can decide to boot up, but by the time you've done the second flash, you see that the partition which I had verified has now been flashed too. So that's how to bypass verified boot is enabled on a Mediatek Android device.